I've got author Sam Brown here. Check it out. This is his book, kind of a field guide for foodies in Houston. How many restaurants in the book?
There are almost 100 of them. And so trying to choose out of so many that are in Houston, I mean, it was hard, but I think when you have a place like this, it's not as hard.
So something obviously made you want to put Guadalupana on the list.
Absolutely. I mean, it's a place where I eat all the time. It helps that I live right across the street, but even if it was a long way away, I would still absolutely
come. There you go, a ringing endorsement. Okay, I've got Roberto with me. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about what you guys offer. I already tried one of the pastries, fantastic, but you have churros. Talk a little bit about the stuff in this window here.
Yeah, we got a mixture of not just Mexican pastries, but we got a little bit of French and Italian. Just to add something for the
variety.
For variety, because, you know, Montrose era is diverse.
It's diverse, absolutely. Yes. Let's talk about the coffee, guys. I'm going to show it to you up here. We've got these bags of coffee, and it's your own very special brand that comes from one specific place.
Exactly. It comes from Puebla, Mexico.
That's my cinnamon taste.
Yes, it's called Café de Olla, and it's the specialty about that is that it has cinnamon, actually flower plant, but it's roasted in a wood-burning oven.
Well, guys, I have tried it. I've probably had too much of it already. It is delicious. There's the coffee right there, and the churro next to it, very popular. But let's talk about some of the breakfast dishes.
Yeah, we have the most popular dish called migas, which is chorizo with tortilla strips and egg with beans. And then we have chilaquiles.
Oh, see, now we're talking. Yeah. Tell everybody what that is in case they don't know.
Yeah, it's pretty much homemade tortilla strips in a green salsa with a queso fresco and some fried eggs and some refried beans. That's a dish that we give Anthony Bourdain when he came over.
So you've had Mr. Bourdain in the show?
Yes, sir. Yeah, very he was cool. Here visiting us.
Very cool. Did he like the food?
Oh, yes, he did. He was speechless after he left.
Guys, there you go. So, like Guadalupana on Dunleavy. Guys, I got to ask you this because, Roberto, I don't know what that is.
That's a very popular drink. It's called Vampiro, which says vampire, translates to vampire, which is fresh squeezed orange juice, carrot juice, and beet juice for all these healthy folks around the area.
I love it's kind of, again, something unique, kind of tailored to the diversity of the area. So I think that's fantastic. All right, so real quick, when are you open? What are the hours?
We're open 7 days a week from 7 in the morning to 3 in the afternoon.
All right, come see Roberto and eat at the joint that Anthony Bourdain was made speechless at. Guys, that's the book. We're checking out one more restaurant headed to the heights for the next hour. We'll see you then.
So fun that you're on this adventure this morning. And look at that. How delicious.
Oh, makes me hungry.
Delicious stuff.
All right, we'll